students, my name is Faisal Khan. In last video, we have discussed how to multiply decimals. And in this video, we will continue with how to divide decimals, how to divide decimal number by 10,000 and 100, how to multiply decimal number by a decimal number, and how to divide a decimal number by a whole number. So, and this is exercise 9, and we will do some solutions of exercise 3C. So starting, we will discuss how to divide a decimal number by 10, 100 or 1000. Divide decimal numbers by 10, 100 or 1000. It is very easy as multiplication. When we multiply by 100 and 1000, we shift decimal towards right. And when we divide a decimal number by 100 and 1000, we just do the opposite of this step. We shift decimal towards its left. So let's take an example. Divide 286.5 by 10. Here we have to divide 286.5 by 10. We can write them as 286.5 divided by 10, or like a fraction, 286.5 upon 10. So here we are dividing it by 10. So what do we do? We will shift. We will count the number of zeros. Here number of zeros 1, and shift. We will shift the decimal place towards it. Left. The number of decimal places 1, so we will shift the decimal towards its left. How many times? How many days? 1 place. So our answer will be 28.65. That means 28.286.5 divided by 10 will give us 28.65. Second, divide same number 28.286.5 by 100. Divide 286.5 by 100. Write them as with the sign of division 28.286.5 divided by 100 or 286.5 upon 100. Here number of zeros 2, so shift the decimal place. Decimal 2 places left towards its two places. We will shift the decimal 2 places towards the left. So we will get our answer 2.865. That means when we divide 286.5, we will get 28.65. Now divide same number by 1000. 286.5 divided by 1000. So 286.5 divided by 1000 equals to 286.5 upon 1000. So number of zeros 3, shift decimal how many places? 3 places towards left. Remind this, when we are multiplying, we shift towards, in multiply, we shift towards right, and in divide, we shift towards left. So shift the decimal towards this left, how many places? 3 places, 1, 2, or 3. So we will get 0.2865, or we can write it as 0.2865. 5. It is our answer. Now, how to divide decimal numbers by whole number? To divide decimal number by whole number, we assume both of them as whole number and divide as whole number, then put the decimal mark according to the number of decimal places in the quotient or in the divisor and dividend. So, assume as whole number, we have 136 divided by 4. Divide it 136 by 4. Divide 1 by 4, it's 1. Divide 13 by 4, 3 times. 4 threes are 12 and remainder 1. Take 16 down, 6 down. Now I have 16. So 16 divided by 4 in 4 times. So finally we get the remainder 0 and our quotient is 34. That means when we divide two whole numbers, 136 divided by 4 give us 34. So when we divide 13.6 divided by 4, we will get the number value as same, but we will have decimal place. We have different decimal places. Number of decimal places here 1. So count the number of decimal. So put the mark of decimal before one place of decimal. So when we divide 13.6 by 4, we will get 3.4 as our answer. That means when we divide a number, a decimal number by a whole number, first we divide them as whole number, then put the decimal mark according to the decimal places given in our question. Now we will discuss how to divide decimal numbers by another decimal number. So, how to divide decimal number by another decimal number? To divide decimal number by another decimal number, first we will convert the denominator, convert them as fraction, then we will remove the decimal point from the denominator, then we divide them as whole number. So, to divide, let's take an example. 3.28 divided by 0.4. Here both the digits are decimal and it has 3 decimal places and it has 1 decimal place. So we can write them as 3.28 divided by 0.4 and convert them as fraction. We will have 3.28 divided by 0.4. Now we have to remove this decimal from the denominator. So what we will do? We will multiply it by the 10,000 or 10,000 with according to the number of decimal places. It has one digit after the decimal places, so we will multiply its denominator and numerator by 10. If it has 2 decimal places, then we will multiply 100. If it has 3 decimal places, then we will multiply by 1000. So we will get 3.28 upon 0.4 into 10. Mention remind this. We do not multiply the 10 only in denominator. We multiply it in both numerator and denominator. It is compulsory. Otherwise, it will change our answer. Now multiply 10 in both numerator and denominator. We are multiplying by the number of 10. so we will shift the 0 towards its right. So we will have 332.8 divided by 4. Now we have a number, we have a decimal number which has to divide by a whole number. Now divide that. 32.8 by 4. 3 divided by 4, it can't happen. So take 2 together with 3, we have 32. 4, in 32 comes at 4 times, 8 times in the table of 4. That means when we multiply 4, 8 times, we will get 32. So 4 is R, 32. Subtract them, we get 0. Now we have to take 8 downward. So but here it is decimal present here. So first we put the decimal, put this decimal, we transfer this decimal to into quotient, then we write down the 8 into s divided. 4 multiplied by 2 times this 8. Now we have our answer, our final answer 0, and the solution is 32.8 divided by 4 gives 8.2. 32.8 divided by 4 comes from 3.28 divided by 4, which is our original question. So 3.28 divided by 0.4 will also give 8.2 as our answer. That means when we have to divide a decimal number by with the denominator or as whole number, then we divide them as this process or the process I tell you this video before. Then we will get our answer, and now here our answer is 3.28 divided by 0.4 is 8.2. Now we will discuss some questions from our exercise. Question number 1, 2 and 3. Question number 1, 2 and 3 are same as the topics I told you. So I will continue with word problems now. Question number 5 of exercise 3C is a bus can cover distance of 631.25 km in 5 minutes. Find the distance covered by it in 1 liter of petrol. Here it is given that in 5 liter petrol, bus can cover total distance 631. We have to find the distance covered by the car in 1 liter. Here the value of more is given and we have to find the value of 1. So in this type of question, what we do when it is given the value of more and we have to find the value of 1, we just divide the total value from the total number of, we will divide the total distance from the total liter of petrol given. So solution is total distance travel by bus is 631.25 km, and the amount of petrol used is 5 liters. So we have to find how much distance it will cover in only 1 liter of petrol. So distance traveled in 1 liter of petrol is, we will divide total distance divided by the total amount of petrol used, 631.25 divided by 5. divided by 631.25 divided by 5. 5 ones are 5 minus the remainder 1. 3 down. 5 twos are 10 remainder 3. Take 1 down. 31. 5 6 are 30 remainder 1. Now here we have decimal. So to take 2 down, we will transfer this decimal in the quotient. We will transfer this decimal into the quotient. So transferring the quotient, after decimal we will get 126 point and take 2 down. 5 twos are 10 remainder 2 and 5 are 25. Now we have remainder 0, so our division is finished and our quotient is 126.25. we have the quotient 126.25. that means the total distance covered by car in 1 liter of petrol is 126.25. so our answer statement will be the distance covered by car bus in 1 liter of petrol is 126.25 kilometers. Now question number 8 is, the product of two numbers is 1.878576. that means it is given that two numbers already had multiplied and their product is 1.8576. one number is given 0.54, we have to find the other number. So assume that the other number is x. So now the product of two numbers, is 1.8576. one number is 0.54. so other number, is 10. So when we multiply this x to this, we will get this. According to the question, when we multiply this x to this, we will get this. To write this equation, like x equation. So x multiplied by 0.54 is equals to 1.8576. Transfer this 0.54 toward right side. Here it is multiplication. When it transfer to right side, it will become a division. So x is equals to 1.8576 divided by 0.54. Here now we get a decimal number divided by decimal number. As I told you, a decimal number by divided by a decimal number by divided by a decimal number, we convert the denominator as whole number by multiplying it 10, 100 or 1000 depending on the decimal places of denominator. Here the number of decimal places in the denominator is 2, so we will multiply it by 100 because 100 has 2 zeros. So x is equals to 1.8576 upon 0.54 is multiplied by 100. And I also told you that we did not multiply 100 only in denominator, we multiply it in numerator and denominator both, because only multiplying in denominator will change our answer. So we are multiplying the 100 in So we will transfer this. It has two decimal places. This decimal places two places after 5. This decimal places two places after 4. We will get 185.76 divided by 54. Now divide them. 185.76 divided by 54. So now make a table of 54. 54 multiplied by 19 gives 54. 54 multiplied by 2 times gives 108. 54 multiplied by 3 times gives 162. And 54 multiplied by 4 times gives 260. Now we can't divide 1 by 54. We can't divide 18 by 54. So we will take 3 digits and it will become 185. So one divide 185 by 54. 185 comes between 162 and 216. So we will take the digit just before the 185. And 162 comes before 185. So we will multiply. We will multiply 54 by 3 and get 162. So our quotient will be 3 and write 162 down to the under 185. Now subtract them. 2 subtracted from 5, 3. 6 subtracted from 8, 2. 54 multiplied by 3, yes, 162. So now subtract it. 2 subtracted from 5, 3, 2, 1110. Now we have to take 7 down, so we will transfer this decimal again in quotient. Now we have to write 37. 54 multiplied by this number gives number equals to 37 or less than 37. 54 multiplied by 4 times gives 216. Now 54 multiplied by 5 times gives 270. So here we can say that 270 is greater than 237 and 216 is less than 237. So we will take 216. So we should multiply 54 by 4 times to get 216. So we will write 4 in quotient and 216 to subtract. Now subtract 7, 6 out of 6 out of 7 is 1, 1 out of 3 is 2, and here 0. Take 6 down. Now again we have 216, and we know that 54 multiplied by 4 times is 216. Finally we got the remainder 0. So the quotient is 3.44. So where we can say that the other number x, which is 3.44, and when we multiply 3.44 to 0.54, we will get 1.8576 as their product. Answer: the other number is 3.44. Now you can solve remaining questions of exercise 3C by using this method. In exercise 3C there are total 8 questions and you have to do rest of the questions by yourself in your homework copy. We will meet in next video. Thank you.